Hey everyone, Opaque, Flake here, welcome you back to the year of Final Fantasy with Final Fantasy VI. Armor shop. Well, the only thing worth buying is a white dress, but I don't have any ladies with me, but it's a really nice white dress. That would be very useful. And I guess a ninja gear wouldn't be that bad either. The thing is, I have those mithril equipment. It's up to you if you want more speed. But because you don't get any evade off it, because of the evade bug, all of the evade is in the magic evade, I suppose, or magic defense. I think it's magic blocker here. So it's entirely up to you. Oh wait, there's no speed on this. Or maybe there is. Eh, no, there isn't. Okay, then fucking don't get the ninja gear. Stick with the myth of this. I don't know why the game doesn't register it as like, oh, it's not really an upgrade, but whatever, man. Or was that the kung fu suit? That was the kung fu suit. Well, there you go. The ninja gear is better than the mithril vest. Just by a little bit. 2 speed, 2 defense, and some magic defense. Everything up by 2. And for me, that's not enough to constitute a reason to buy it. Since I got the mithril vest for free, so yeah. But apparently Zozo is a very, dickish town with thieves and whatnot. But it makes sense. Next to a town with, if not in the same town or area, next to it, there's another town that's full of shit beside a rich town. It's just how it works, man. Every JRPG needs an auction house. Unfortunately, this one won't work until later on. It's funny how he uses poor, but they use dorky. And that kid, man. That fucking kid. You gotta hate that kid. There's a reason to hate that kid. But that kid. Well, his dad's rich. Really rich. So, what are you gonna do? You can't talk to those lovely ladies either. But yes, once I'm done talking to these NPCs, I can begin the hardest part of the game in terms of difficulty spike, I suppose. Again, it's where the game starts picking up, and it really does pick up with Zozo, which we'll be entering soon enough. Truth be told, I don't think you even had to come here. You could have just gone straight to Zozo, but I might as well show all this shit off. I mean, if you want more earrings, go for it. It's pretty expensive, though. Pretty good though. Like, if you're using Gao, Celeste, Terra, and they're the only ones who can use magic. Well, if he has Sabin and he has Fire Dance, you give him earrings. His portrait's kind of already wearing earrings, so it kind of fits. Well, I may be dorky, but you're one tinctureless person, I suppose. Goddamn poor people building their own town. How dare they? Without money, how did they build it? They were poor! Anywho, weapons. Get a Kodachi. Yeah, I was thinking of Rurouni Kenshin, sorry. It's like, wait a minute. Plus, I was thinking of something else, but anyways, if you want to get a forge, go for it. 81 battle power. Is it worth it? Not really, because science is not worth it at all. Sorry, Cyan, you suck. By the by, I think if you bring Shadow, you can start working up in the Shadow Dream side quest or sub quest or extra dialogue exposition to its background and whatnot. It's up to you. I'm gonna do it later. But as that one NPC mentioned, Zozo is a town full of a bunch of liars, thieves, and poor people who built their own town. Iron Fist, meet the brawler. Now Gao is fucking pissed. Although I did show it off, I guess it's worth mentioning now. You can't really steal from aerial enemies. And there you go, stone. Really useful. Confused, does okay damage. Not that bad. Funny thing is, Joe's really good, it's just that it's gonna get replaced really quick, assuming you know what to do. Otherwise, eh. But I don't know, man, it's like this whole trip up here is kind of useless because the enemies here suck, but they are gonna help you a bit. I mean, Zozo's a really tough town. It's like really tough, actually. Unless you have Gao here and you got at least Marshall and Stray Cat. I think Overmind would help too. I'm bringing Edgar because Noise Blaster is gonna help out a lot. And then you got his other attacks, especially an item he gets in Zozo that really does wreck. But it's not so much the number of enemies they throw at you, it's more along the lines of what they can do and how hard they hit individually. There's only like one enemy that is not that threatening, but more along the lines of a fucking annoying. And when it pops up, you'll see why. In the meantime, I like using Flash, but Auto Crossbow is still fine too as well. I think 7 minutes Fire Dance around 13 or 15 too. Because it's going to be really useful here if I had learned it level 12. I think on my first or second playthrough I already had Fire Dance, so I mean, I did kill a lot of stuff back then, so there's that to consider. Oh man, Zozo. It's so fucking beautiful. But remember, everyone here is a liar. And here's that annoying enemy I was referring to. The Harvester. They're not that bad in terms of how hard they hit, I suppose. It's more along the lines of that they steal from you. And they can steal something really nice. And well, thanks for showing it off, but they use potions as well. But just use a Noise Blaster and you're fine. Unfortunately, I have that Slam Dancer to worry about. Here's the thing, the Slam Dancer is either easy or hard. Hard because you don't want to leave it alive alone. Because it casts level 2 magic. And level 2 magic can essentially kill you here if you're not at full health. It does like 280 damage or something like that. And I got a barrier ring. And apparently, I don't know, man, that's where the difficulty spike comes in. As a kid, I didn't realize that, but now I do. It's like, oh, hey, it's not that bad. It's just, you know, don't keep it alive. Last, kill it first. That's pretty much all there is to it. Of course, you're going to want to steal from all of the enemies here. They all have nice stuff. I think Slam Dancers have a nice head equipment, I think. While these guys have a nice relic. It's not that great though, but it's unique, to say the least. This is where Edgar comes into shine. His drill would just, you know, control the Slam Dancer and you're good. If not Gao, but you're definitely going to want to stay at full health here. But that one dude said the clock's second hand's at 30. He's lying, so don't believe him then. The second hand's never at 30. This whole area has an infamous clock puzzle where everyone in the town, I believe, has a hint to solving it, I suppose. So I would suggest either writing them all down and then ignoring all the hints, because they're all lying. So just use that, whatever you wrote down, as a guide to not using it, I suppose. That's pretty much the only advice I can give you at this point. I already know what the puzzle, I guess, to me is not a puzzle anymore, it's just something I just input, like in Final Fantasy VII with a rocket. I already know what the answer is, but I'm gonna get it right away because it's really good for Edgar. But I guess it's kind of hard to figure out. Holy shit, I've never seen you guys do that move before. You threw a knife at me. You're not Shadow. I need more items then. And he was in the back rope too, mind you. They'll hit just as hard. Really good idea to bring Celeste though, because the slam dancers can't do shit if you have Runic up, so. This is why you don't want to fight a slam dancer last. Ice 2. 260 to 280 damage. Very much so, ow. And gobbledygooks. They're called gobbledygags here, but limitations, I suppose. Please run away, second tent. Thank you. Oh man, now would be a good time to equip the reflect ring, I suppose. Now let's fight these damn gobbledygooks. They're actually pretty easy now that I think about it. Why did I think they were hard? God damn it, man. Give me the, relic. I was about to spoil it what it was. Gabaldegook. This is so weird when you read it like that. Gabaldegook. Pretty sure it's gobbledygook, though. Or I could be wrong, it's just my own headcanon. Okay, he didn't give me a hint about the clock, so maybe he's not the one. So, the answer is pretty simple if you got all the results, but, well. Essentially, you get all the stuff. I fucked up on purpose, by the way. You get enough of the stuff to cross these out, and then from there, it's either... You have like two to choose on from each category except minutes. Minutes is pretty easy to figure out. Because they only tell you like one advice. The clock does, I think it says like... One of the clocks is stuck at the two hand, which is 10. And then from there you just scratch out the rest of the seconds. Because there's like four hints for seconds or three. But you get a nice reward for all this though. You get a chainsaw. No one can equip it. But Edgar here can use it. And the cool thing about the chainsaw is that it has instant death. And he wears a Jason mask. So, it's fitting. Also, don't want to deal with her. And if Edgar doesn't do instant death, he just fucking goes apeshit with the chainsaw. And, well, there you go. Wait a minute. Why does he have a Jason mask with a chainsaw? Shouldn't it be a machete? I guess, I don't know. You know Japan, they just, like... Oh, horror movies, Chainsaw Jason. Yeah, let's go with that. Because it's supposed to be the Leatherface that uses a chainsaw. Ah, whatever, I don't give a fuck. It's a video game. Anyways, I pretty much already figured out the puzzle, or showed it for you, so... All that's left for me to do is just to climb the tower. There's not many items here left to begin with. The fucking slum. You can't even buy or sell anything here, it's just here to fuck with you. But if you do get a lot of goggles because of the thief knife, they're actually a good source of selling stuff. Well, I mean, you're not going to use them. For one thing, the evade bug is fucked up here, so you don't need to protect against blind at all. Which are some really badass glasses. In fact, I'll give everyone blind if I had a chance, but... The other thing is, you're gonna get so many, it's just... Because I want the relic, I'm gonna try to get it. But for now, eh. In the meantime, there's only a few more things I can explore. And talk to the NPCs, I suppose. So it's never pointing to the right time anyway. It's always pointing at the right time. But it's just a minute hand, so... Hence, that's where the 10 comes from. Speaking of which, I think you get a bunch of, Well, I've been getting a lot of barrier rings, so... Maybe that's what you have to sell. Surprisingly enough, I think he's telling the truth. Kind of. This is gonna take a while too. So what I'm gonna do is just gonna wait here, make the line get bigger. You should be good. But there is one enemy you should really be fearful of outside. I haven't run into him yet, but Edgar's chainsaw makes it so much simpler and safer. But also having Gao in your party is gonna be so much better as well. I think that's it. So 3, 6, 7. Yep, 7-0. So if you ever fuck up, by the way, just have Gao just get on a rage for anyone that was floating. I use the Telstar since I already got it. Also, drops Green Berets a lot. I don't know if I already mentioned that, but if you want more Green Berets and it's the very beginning of the game and you fought the Telstar and the Velt, you run into it, you can get it. But Gao is the only one right now who can have float in the party. And one of the enemies over there has, outside of the buildings, has a powerful attack that requires you to have float if you want to stay alive. I think that's the only way you can stay alive, honestly. Ah, fuck. Here I thought I was doing well. And there goes Gao. You know what? Chainsaw. Just, you can steal something really nice from him. But chainsaw. He didn't do it right. Run! Run. Ah, fuck it. It's gonna be a game over for me if I don't run. I shit you not. When you kill this motherfucker, he'll give you a send-off gift. And he fucking is like, nah, this motherfucker's floating. I'm gonna fucking kill him right now. That bastard. And I'm low on potions too. The goal was to survive this and then just go back to using Celis, which is kind of gonna be mandatory in a sense. But anyways, I got the Thief Glove. Basically, it makes your attack turn into capture, which is mug. You don't really need that because you have the Sneak Ring, so it's kind of counterintuitive unless you're not using the Genji Glove or the Thief Dagger, which you should be. But anyways, that one dude said, don't jump the buildings, so jump the buildings. Actually, that was good advice, but, you know, like, advice to not hurt yourself. But that one guy was doing it, so we're gonna do it. Please, man, give me the fucking item I want. I don't want to grind it. I mean, it's a useless relic. I think it's useless, but I don't know. I mean, it depends who uses it, but at the same time, using regular attacks here is kind of useless to begin with. It's all about magic and their abilities. For Sabin, it's Blitz. For Edgar's tools, Lock sucks. Terra and Solace is magic, but I mean, what are you gonna do? So there you go, whatever the second hand's pointing at 4, don't use those for the clock. And this dude, 20. Oh man, Harvester stole like 4,000 gil or something. But I gotta say though, I really want to fight a Gigas only because I have something nice to steal. It was either a Gaia Gear or an Atlas Armlet. Atlas? It was Atlas something, I think. Oh fuck. Kill it quick. Shit. Whoa, what? Wow, I actually canceled. See, they usually do cast all Ice 2 or Fire 2 on you. Not singular. Maybe just Reflect canceled it? I don't know. Because I know you can Reflect more than once, though, so. You know, I'm just going to take the luck. Thank you. Another Gigas. Alright, give me a Pterodon. Do whatever damage you want. Chainsaw is usually an instant death, so you should be good with that. Maybe I can stay alive if I try. Wow, you didn't counter with that. Is it because I killed him with magic? Well, there you go. And I got a fire knuckle. Gal's the only one who can get float, so... Damn, that is a huge increase. That's almost double. I want to fight one more. But maybe I shouldn't, considering. I got lucky. I mean, I'll save and look for it, because I do want it. I also want what the harvesters have, so... There you go. Should be able to do this, though. Can't really do anything on this way. He's in your way. What a fight, gentle.
Hey, wait a minute.
Of course he's gonna be a boss. Daruluma. Dude's kinda tough. I mean, not if you have Gal, but... Or the chainsaw, so... Dude can be tough, I suppose. Why did you try to instant death the boss? Come on. That's the only downside against chainsaw against bosses. Tries to instant death them. But I got a jewel ring, so... That's nice, I suppose. Sometimes he does potion, I believe. Wow, only tonics. Once he does that, that means he's almost dead, so I'm kind of curious to why he's doing that. Also, why the fuck you keep on doing that, Edgar? Come on. You're holding the team back. Well. They're not that tough, but... These dicks. Kinda forgot they die with them. I don't think you get anything because you killed the boss and not them, so... If you wanted more GP and experience, kill them. Then Daruluma. I should be fine. Thank you. Ah, the opera scene. Such a great place, memorable in every other way. Anyways, gonna have to come back here later. Very, very important to have sprint shoes on. Unless you're playing the PlayStation or Game Boy Advance version. I forget which one has the native running option, where you don't have to have the sprint shoes. Anyways, let's go talk to Maria. And this is where the sprint shoes, my friends, come in handy. Unless, again, you're playing the Game Boy Advance or PlayStation 1 version, where it's really fucking simple. By the way, pressing these fucks with the opera. Also fucks with you and your time, so wouldn't recommend pressing it. Because honestly, you really don't want a game over. By the way, I did learn a new Blitz with Sabin, Fire Dance. He's a level 15 now. Everyone has their espers equipped. Off the top of my head, I think... I actually forget who has what, honestly, so... just gonna have to make do with what I remember. I know for a fact that Celeste has Ramu. I think Locke has Kirin, whatever does the cure. Gao has Stray? And... or Siren. And Seven has Stray or Siren. Whatever has fire. I show it to you, but the menu kind of also takes up time as well. Also, one of those rats respawn enemies too, so... worth keeping a mention to, but... since Celeste isn't using it, I'm gonna give it to Sabin, because he already finished the whole Esper thing. I think I fucked up Fire Dance. I didn't.
Lucky me.
And by that I mean, unlucky me, because this is taking time. You can actually skip these guys, but I'm not really gonna bother. I should be able to kill them really quick. I just think dodging them takes too long, honestly. I don't know how the hell that touched me, but whatever. I think I'm gonna have enough time just to heal up. But I'm glad Locke learned a cure by now. I should have let him keep it though. Now that I think about it, kind of fucked up right there. I say that because espers give you stat upgrades when they level up. Well, additional stat upgrades for those who are into minimizing and maximizing, but it kind of matters for me right now because I want Gao to get more magic power. So his wind slash does more damage, but... I mean, it's not too crucial, I suppose. I was kind of hoping he would do wind slash, but oh well. That's what happens if you don't kill Vermin quick enough. I can't believe I fucked up Fire Dance. But as you saw in the last fight, Wind Slash even hits enemies from the other side of the pincer attack, so... it's just an amazing move. Hey, I got enough time to even unequip Sprint Shoes. Or the Thief Glove. Kinda premature for me to equip a guy with earrings and the barrier ring and the ribbon and the hero ring, but... there's reason to behind that. I'll have him learn Regen, then I'll stop. In the meantime... it really doesn't matter what Gao learns, because he's gonna be raging for the most time, which is why I give him the lackluster ones, but... I mean, if you want him to get stat upgrades, that's the reason why I gave him the, other stuff. But Sabin's gonna get some extra magic, which is good. I have a lot of time to carry now, which is why I'm doing this. Man, I love this boss battle track so much. I forgot I equipped the wrong one now. Now that I saw the fucking capture there, but oh well. What are you gonna do? I don't know if slow works on him. Let's find out. But Ultra's has changed as well. It's a little bit more, wily. And there you go. I forget what this does, though. Yeah, let's find out. I think this is Shell? Or was it Reflect? No, it's Regen. Okay, well, there you go. That position down there is a worse because it's Muddle. Gee, Ultros, I didn't know there was another kind of octopus. Oh boy. Oh, surprisingly, it didn't do that much damage. God damn it. I should be using Aurora Bolt, but Ultras is still weak against fire. Anyways, this is gonna wrap up the whole part nicely, so with that said and done, thanks for watching this part of Let's Play Final Fantasy VI with me, Opaque, part of your Final Fantasy. Okay, thanks, bye.